Texas pastor calls for imposing Christian nationalist values on society. Like, they're just going full mask off. Let's do it in the open now. Cool. Texas megachurch pastor Robert Jeffress, a supporter of Christian nationalism, called out to conservative Christians to, quote, impose their values on society. In a recent interview with Tim Clinton, the host of Real America's Voice, Robert Jeffress said that loving their country and voting in elections is all good for Christians, but they must put God above everything else. He also said, quote, the left doesn't mind at all imposing their values on our country through the election process. They don't mind forcing their pro-abortion, pro-transgender, pro-open borders policy upon our nation, but they object when conservative Christians try to impose their values on society at large. It's complete hypocrisy, end quote. When the pastor was asked about the issues that Christians and pastors face before the midterm elections, he stated that it is almost the same thing that even atheists are worried about, such as inflation, high interest rates, crime, and border control. Jeffress had previously denied any allegations of him being a so-called Christian nationalist. Armin, where are you? Okay, he's
right here. Okay, what does this mean? Imposing? How does that work?
Well, I actually have in the show notes, I have the video of him talking about it, so it might be more fun to actually like hear him say it and respond.
There we go. Okay, where's the video?
No, in the show notes, not on the page.
Oh, okay, hold
on. Because I found the clip later.
On Rumble?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, these people must be really crazy.
I could only find the clip on Rumble.
Yeah, like if you're on Rumble, I'm not on YouTube. I don't know what kind of people we're dealing with. By the way, we had
so
two
Armin, I would love to see
I forgot
you
to read. Yeah.
Do a reaction to this.
Okay, let's do it. Let me know if you have an audio. By the way, I know that we had two super chats. I forgot to read them. I will read them after this news. Okay.
Yes.
We always put our love for God above everything, even allegiance to our country. But that's not what they're really talking about. Listen carefully. They say they are opposed to people who say America was founded as a Christian nation, Americans who believe not only in the spiritual heritage of our nation, but believe that we ought to use elections to help return our country to its Christian foundation. If that's Christian nationalism, count me in, because that's what we have to do. And what's so hypocritical about this, Tim, is the left don't mind at all imposing their values on our country through the election process. They don't mind forcing their pro-abortion, pro-transgender, pro-open borders policy upon our nation, but they object when conservative Christians try to impose their values on society at large. It's complete hypocrisy.
I want to get your immediate reaction to that statement.
Okay, I think this person doesn't understand that the United States is not a pure democracy. Okay, so it's not imposing. The United States is this is something that the Republicans keep telling us. Now I have to remind them of the same thing. Okay, this is not a absolute democracy. This country is a republic. I thought you guys knew that. Okay, so there are limitations to what you could do through the ballots. Okay, you can't just force your way. So the things that the Christian values that you want to impose on us through elections are, because this country is a liberal democracy and the minorities' rights are protected, okay, through its constitution, that means that your Christian values have to take a back seat, even if you have the majority vote. That's how a republic works, sir. I mean, this is like, I thought the conservatives always say that to the liberals, like, this is not a democracy, this is a republic. Well, yeah, that means that you cannot impose your way on minorities, on trans people, on gay people. Their rights will be protected even if you loons manage to somehow get the majority of the country to vote a certain way.
And I think there's a disconnect or like a misunderstanding, or maybe there's no desire for understanding of like in not all cases, okay, in the majority of like the values that he's talking about coming from the left, it's calling them an imposition of your values on society is inaccurate, because these are values that are supposed to be for the protections of people's liberties to then go do what they want to their extent.
Yeah, that's why it's a liberal.
Did that make sense?
Yes, yes. There's certain, you know, you feel like we're imposing things on. Okay, they understand them not being able to take people's rights away as us imposing certain values on them. Like, but I mean, technically, it's true.
Exactly.
We are forcing you not to, you know, have slaves. Okay, that way of life, for example, is being forced upon you. Okay, I mean, but it's in the same way that you are being imposed not to be able to murder. Okay, like even if you manage to like get the majority of the country to be like, hey, let's be pro-murder. Okay, or let's bring back an eye to an eye. Okay, well, yes, it's being imposed on you. But that's why this country works. It's a liberal democracy. That's why, you know, you can't bring back slavery through the ballot or through democracy. You can't bring back torture, for example. I mean, the United States does torture, but like at least on the books, you don't have legally, you're not supposed to be able to torture, right? But yeah, I mean, this is because the United States is a liberal democracy. It's not a Christian nation. He thinks that this is an anti-constitution position. You know what I mean? You are complaining about the fact that the constitution has been imposed upon you.
Mm-hmm.
Which is weird.
Well, it's really interesting. This later, he goes on to mention that essentially, what is mobilizing Christians in this election is this whole cultural reckoning we're having with transgender issues. And in that sense, I actually think he's right. Like, I do think that this is a major influence right now and a major motivator that is getting the Christian right extremely active. You can see it everywhere. Like, I really think that is a major, like, cultural touchstone that our country is having like a reckoning over, and it's kind of becoming like a sides that you can just pile on to then go take your culture war whatever way you want. But none of this stuff is actually improving the lives of Americans. Like, what is this doing for inflation? Like, where are our policy positions in areas that will actually benefit and help increase prosperity for average Americans? It's like so lacking. So instead they pick on these kind of things.
I mean, to be fair to Biden, he has been trying to do everything he can to deal with the inflation situation as much as he can. We're dealing with like after COVID stuff and Ukraine stuff. Like, he's not God. Presidents have very little over inflation. So, but the amount that he does, he has been doing all of it. So there has been policies over all of these things. I don't know.
I was speaking more about in terms of like opposition, like Republican forces, like what are they offering?
Oh, they have nothing. That's why they have to deal
with
China.
That's what I'm saying. So instead they pick on this.
Yeah, they have to battle. They have to fight the cultural war because they have nothing to offer. By the way, guys, if you're American, please go vote. I mean, like, guys, this is literally the whole planet is at stake.
What? Darko is saying them litter boxes, though. Do you know what this is in reference to?
No, what is it reference to?
There was fake news going around that the transgender movement has gone so far that they are now recognizing children as furries. And that there was a third grade student that demanded that the teacher provide them a litter box so that they could use the litter box because they identify as a cat. And this was, people were circulating this like this was an actual thing that happened. It did not happen. This is completely fake. It's meme.
It's amazing how these right-leaning people think something like that would have happened and it wouldn't be all over all the news all the time everywhere. Like, oh yeah, this just one politician happened to have heard about it. It would have gone viral. Like, every single Republican, every single like anti-SJW person would have picked up on that and it would have gone viral. But no, just this one politician said, like, oh, I just heard somebody somewhere. Yeah, like, sure.
Joe Rogan repeated that to Tulsi Gabbard. He's like, yeah, my friend told me that this happened at his school.
Oh my God, this man has lost all credibility. Seriously. Joe Rogan. I don't even know.
And then later he admitted that it was not real.
Jeez. The fact that he believed it, like, do you really seriously believe that that could have happened and your friend told you and it didn't go viral? Do you know that would be that every single anti-SJW in the entire country and beyond United States would have jumped on that, jump on that whole news and
shared it. They did anyways, and it wasn't real.
Oh my God. Yo, my friend told me. Sure. Hey, we have some comments that I want to highlight.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, so I'm going to do Rebecca's first and then go to GJ. GJ, am I saying it right? Because his comments are from the previous news. So Bread of Life, or Rebecca, our friendly Christian supporter, is saying, Christians should be leading the way with respect for all people. Unfortunately, Christianity in America has become known for lack of respect for transgender and gay people. Jesus says it like that. Well, Rebecca, I don't agree with you, okay? Jesus was racist, and Christianity is anti-gay, but you're not, Jesus, so I appreciate that. Jesus was racist, yes. Jesus was racist. Jesus also hated trees. Certain trees.
You're always stuck on that tree. It's so funny.
Also, pigs as well. Unfortunately, like, made a whole bunch of pigs commit suicide without their consent.
Why would you do that?
Why would you do that, Jesus? Poor pigs. Yeah. Okay.
Brother Ben also, is saying trees are people too.
Also, unbelievers, Jesus is going to let us burn in the lake of fire.
True. Rebecca doesn't believe in that.
No, Rebecca thinks we're going to die for a little bit, not for eternity, I think. Like, we're going to burn and we're going to die. She
doesn't believe in hell.
Oh, no, yeah. Okay, we're going to have a chance. We're going to have a chance. Oh, yeah.
Rebecca, we got a chance, okay, Armin.
Yeah, we got a chance. One last chance.
Thank you, Rebecca, for giving us a chance.
I mean, I don't understand the whole point of believing in Jesus at all. If you get one last chance right after your death, you can see literally, like, okay, this thing is real. So what's the point of, like, believing in Jesus? Everybody in their right mind at that point would be like, okay, sure, I guess you're real. This story, Rebecca's story, only makes sense if there are certain people that would be like, even now I would reject Jesus. Because if without that, hell would be empty. Okay, I think that based on Rebecca's story, there would be two people, maybe three people in hell. The entirety of hell would have like three people in it. Now I'm seeing God and I'm seeing Jesus. And even now I will reject you. Yes, eternal fire, I'll accept that. Sure. Okay. Anyways,
the moral of the story is that Rebecca is a very nice Christian who is too nice to condemn us to hell. And so, yeah.
Yes.
Which I appreciate.
I appreciate
that. We love Rebecca on this channel.
Get my best-selling book, Why There Is No God, for free. Click on the link for it in the description.